Today we're making crepes, also known as French flapjacks, which are thin, edible, foldable, wrappable, rollable food paper stuffed with lumps, clumps, creams, and chunks. Crepes have three main ingredients: milk, flour, and eggs. If you explore recipes out there, you'll find a million different ratios of ingredients, some including melted butter and oil. We're gonna make a savory crepe batter, starting with a third cup of wheat dust. To which I'll add one large egg and Wangjangle until I've got delicious raw egg pudding. Then I'll slowly add some, but not all, of the 3/4 cup of milk we need and continue Wangjangling because this is the environment in which clumps cannot survive. You can go ahead and add all the milk at once, and I can go ahead and welcome you to clump hell. This applies to adding liquids to all kinds of edible and non-edible powders. If you don't like Wangjangling, you can always tie your whisk to a string and twist it up to make an auto spangjangler. We'll also add in 1/4 teaspoon of salt. If you want sweet crepes, just add in 1 teaspoon or so of sugar, or a lot more if you want. I probably shouldn't have beaten air into these because it just adds extra oxygen calories. The most important thing is to remember that you're not making pancakes, so if your batter is pancake thick, you need more milk or water until it's the consistency of heavy cream. Or you can remove some of the flour with a wheat magnet. Now, most recipes will tell you that you have to rest the batter for an hour, but I'm not gonna wait. Too much oil or butter in the pan will mess up your crepes.
And you don't need that in your life!
So after putting in a bit of butter, I'm wiping it out with a paper towel, being careful to avoid skin-on flaming hot pan contact, and then wipe that extra butter onto some delicious popcorn. You want the batter to cover the whole surface, which you do by giving it a swirl. You can also use the blow dryer method if you like your crepes to have a giant hole in the middle. And if you have an untiltable pan, you can keep it still while you tilt the room. You'll know they're ready to flip when you get these brown crispy crusticles forming along the edges. Take a peek and it should start to have these golden brown synapses forming. Ooh, that's a smart looking crepe. I like to blow the edge of the crepe so it's cooler to grab onto, and also so I make sure to spread enough bacteria on it before I eat it. Lift, blow, grab, flip. Also known as the Libigafa process. If you're making a crepe for someone else, make sure you only have their bacteria in your mouth before you blow on it. Now, you don't have to hang your crepes out to dry. In fact, you shouldn't hang your crepes out to dry because that's not something anyone does. Now, put inside the crepe whatever you believe in. I believe in ham, cheese, and egg, which is kind of classic, but you might believe in salami, broccoli, and ghosts. It's up to you. Fold one side in, fold the other side in, run full speed into your tripod, then fold the other sides in. A traditional courtship practice in France involves burning a message to your crush onto a crepe and hoping they absorb the message when they eat it. It's also possible to roll a crepe into a food cylinder. If you're not good at that, you can just make a crepe straw and suck the ingredients directly into your mouth. For this sweet crepe, I'll throw in some chocolate and then do the double fold into a triangle, then top with strawberries. This wasn't good at all because my chocolate ended up tasting bitter, which is coincidentally how I felt on Valentine's Day, because I got a parking ticket that day. You can also fold one into a crepe-a-dia, not to be confused with crepe-a-diem, which is when you rob a liquor store while eating crepes just to feel alive, man. If you want to make a keto crepe, just take a piece of lettuce and roll it flat, then throw in your toppings. And then pretend you're in France while you watch the weight just melt away.
When you're making crepes, you want them to be great.
Yeah, yeah, you want them to be
great. Get them off the pan and onto your plate, then shove them in your face.
Yeah, yeah, shove them in your face.
Then you start to grind with incisors, canines, and saliva to pulverize the bites down into a much more digestible paste. Then swallow down that grape.
Yeah.